firefighters have really been hammering these hillsides, Jim. That's one hot spot over my shoulder there. You can see it kind of smoldering. These hot spots are a huge concern for firefighters. But take a look at this charred hillside. Firefighters, when we came up on this, a lot of this was on fire. It's burned all the way down the ridge, and they've been hitting this area with water from the sky, but also trying to keep an eye on anything that might flare up again. It is the winds here that are a huge concern. Here's what a firefighter told us just a short time ago. Is it better today versus yesterday?
What's better today is we're going to have more forces in place to combat the fire with. What's probably going to be worse today is the weather.
You're just going to let this thing burn right into the ocean.
That's the plan. When we have this much wind behind it, that's really about all we can do. We get on the flanks, we want to get on the side of it, we try to contain it, and we try to run this thing right into the Pacific Ocean.
No. So what you're seeing again, the charred hillsides, this is the northern part of this 10,000 acre fire. This is a large fire that covers so much land here. A lot of homes still under mandatory evacuation. A lot of residents are at some of these evacuation centers watching their television, trying to figure out if this fire is going to affect their houses. Jim, this is a very early start to fire season. We're seeing conditions and fires that you normally see in October. Here, it is only May. Jim?
Wow. And California fire officials told us just that earlier today on the Situation Room. And Kyung, I have to ask you, you look like you're in a safer location than where you were earlier this afternoon or earlier today. When I was looking at your live pictures from earlier, the sky around you looked red. It looked like it might have been difficult to breathe. What is it like for these firefighters battling these flames right now?
Well, I'm in the same location. We haven't moved. The conditions changed, and they can change rapidly. We're talking in just minutes, the sky will go from being red to being pretty clear because of the shifting winds, very strong winds. What firefighters are going through is not just dealing with those winds, but I'm actually going to just pull up a piece of brush here. Look. You can just crack this stuff right in your hands, make it completely disappear. Imagine if you put fire to that. That is what firefighters are facing. Then they've got to put on the suits. They've got to stay hydrated and deal with all of these conditions at the same time. So a very tough job for firefighters. And again, it's just May.